Welcome to Appalachian Bonsai. This video is one of a series to discuss soil components and some of their properties as they pertain to bonsai. These components are what were available to me at this particular time. What's available to you may vary by region, by country. When it comes to bonsai soil, no two-person soil mixtures are alike. Each soil mixture depends upon the species, the climate, and the person who's using them. I hope that just seeing these components in testing will allow you to make choices for your own. Thanks for watching. Today we're going to look at water retention and a little bit on drainage. All plants need water, so let's see how much water these components hold. Both organic and inorganic materials were considered. Just because something holds moisture doesn't make it good. Conversely, just because it might not absorb moisture doesn't make it bad. I began by measuring equal volumes of each component, then measured their dry weights for reference. Next, I added distilled water to each type and let it soak for 1 hour. This should allow plenty of time for each type of soil to fully saturate. After 1 hour, the components are removed from the water and allowed to drain. Each is weighed out over time to calculate retention. Let's see the differences. We'll begin with organic materials. Coconut coir is commonly used in flower baskets and hydroponics. It is sold in brick form and soaks up water like a sponge. It fills the entire cup. That's a lot of water. But all available space is filled, which isn't necessarily good for bonsai. We'll look more on that type of drainage in another video. After draining for 1 hour and 45 minutes, we weighed each sample. We weighed the samples again 3.5 hours later. By comparing the different weights, we are able to determine the amount of water retained and a basic percentage of loss. At 129 grams of water retained plus minimal loss, coconut coir ranks number one with organic material water retention. This is mushroom compost, bought in bags at my local nursery. It is damp at purchase time, so I oven dried it before I used it. Small twigs and sand may be present, and the content will vary depending on where you purchase. It drains well and has a slight alkalinity. I'll do a video on pH at a later date. At 26 grams of water retained and 31.5% loss, compost comes in at number 3 with water retention for organic material. Sphagnum moss is found in cooler, damper regions of the world and is known to hold moisture very well. However, in the United States, commercially available peat moss comes in a fine kiln-dried powder, unlike fresh sphagnum. In this processed form, it does not wet easily, much like baking flour. More information will be available in a future video. You can see that it has absorbed very little water and is actually floating on top. If powdered peat moss in a soil mix is allowed to dry out, potential dead zones may occur. If it is saturated, powdered peat moss will hold plenty of moisture, but for this test, it did not perform well. After draining for 5.25 hours, peat moss only held 6 grams of water with 40% loss. It ranks number 4 on the organic list. Pine bark and fir bark are fan favorites in the bonsai world. I have pine bark available in my region. Here, pine bark chips can be sold as soil conditioner. I sift it to a proper size and put the rest in the garden. The sifted bark drains well and holds good moisture. Beneficial microorganisms like bacteria can thrive in these porous structures. And as a quick note, pine bark is on the acidic side. At retaining 22 grams of water at a 14.8% loss, pine bark comes in at number 2 in organic water retention. Let's look at inorganic materials and aggregates. Akadama is the classic gold standard of Japanese bonsai mixtures. Here in most of the US, it is expensive and not readily available. It is often purchased online or at dedicated bonsai nurseries. Its large particle size drains well and its porosity absorbs and retains moisture. Because of the expense and its scarcity outside of Japan, people around the world look for alternatives to Akadama. With water retention of 22 grams at a 26.6% loss, Akadama ranks number 2 overall in inorganic material. Diatomaceous earth, or diatomite, is a lightweight fired calcium clay that is used as an absorbent in kitty litter and oil dry. This product needs to be sifted well before use. It also compacts and breaks down over time, but we will look at that in another video. Like Akadama, it absorbs and retains moisture very well, and in fact, retains more water than Akadama. At 37 grams of water retained, with 30% loss, Diatomaceous Earth comes in at number 1 overall ranking. Chicken grit, or granite chips, is a popular aggregate in soil mixtures. Its popularity stems from its excellent drainage, its inert structure, and it's pretty cheap. It's also one of the heaviest components used. The color depends on the quarry, and for the most part is non-porous and absorbs little water. Most of the water retained is merely from surface tension. With only 1 gram of water retained and a 94.4% loss, granite chips rank last in our list of inorganic materials. Expanded shale is becoming more available as a soil component because of its ability to prevent compaction. It has a semi-porous structure and can absorb some moisture. The large particle size I had available to me drains very well. It has a good color too. Unlike some other expanded materials, this one does not break down easily over time. With only 2 grams of water and 84.6% loss, expanded shale ranks number 9 on the inorganic list. Lava rock, which is sometimes known as scoria, is a hard yet porous material with excellent drainage. Its large pores absorb some moisture and can house beneficial bacteria. It also has a pretty color, which makes it a good choice for top dressing. Similar to expanded shale and granite, it can last a long time without breaking down. With 4 grams of water retained at 76% loss, lava rock or scoria ranks number 8 overall in inorganic material. Perlite is a type of volcanic glass that is expanded with high heat. It is common in growing mediums here in the U.S. Its porous structure allows it to float, but much like lava rock and granite, much of the water retained is through surface tension. Also like these other components, it does not break down easily over time. One of the problems for bonsai is its stark white color. This usually means it's only used for training trees and not for formal presentations. At 14 grams of water and 36% loss, this product ranks number 6 on our list. Pumice is a less dense but more porous variety of lava rock. It, like processed perlite, will float. And like nearly all materials that you use in bonsai, you need to make sure that you sift it and wash it good before you use it. It drains well and is similar to Akadama in its ability to hold and retain good moisture. With 22 grams of water retained and only 29% loss, pumice holds the number 3 rank for inorganic material. Sand is one of the most available components around the world. It's also the heaviest of the components that we tested. Small grains of sand can easily block drainage, so it must be sifted well before use. Sand also drains very well, but the majority of the moisture held within it is from surface tension and not from absorption. With 12 grams of moisture retained and 67.5% loss, sand ranks number 7 on our list. Turface is a type of lightweight expanded clay aggregate, or LECA. It is one of the most common bonsai soil mediums used outside of Japan. It readily absorbs moisture, but like all of these components, it does have some drawbacks that will be discussed later in another video. Turface drains well and has a very good color. Though it's relatively stable, it can break down over time. Turface held 30 grams of water with 36% loss. This ranks it number 4 on our inorganic list. Vermiculite is sold in various forms, including this expanded type. Its most common use in the gardening world is to break up clay soils. Its use in bonsai depends upon the person. Even though it floats along the surface, it does absorb moisture without becoming soggy. There is potential for vermiculite's small size to clog drainage. Because of its 28 grams of retention with 41.6% loss, vermiculite comes in at number 5. Bees. Again, this is not a full list of components used for bonsai soil mixtures, but what were available to me at this time. I have more tests to show you, so stick around. Leave a comment in the section below about what types of tests you'd like to see me perform in the future. If you haven't already, follow us on Facebook or Instagram.
Stay tuned, because there's always more to come. Thanks for watching.